Hey guys, what's up, Jason here. Welcome back to a brand new video. Now today we're doing the reaction on Trevor Daniel and Selena Gomez Past Life Remix featuring Lil Mosey, the official audio. Now, don't know who Trevor Daniel is? Everyone knows who Selena Gomez is, especially if you were born in my generation or just any generation, probably in general. She's hella famous and popular. From TV shows, y'all, or we probably watched and everything growing up, everyone knows Selena Gomez for that. Her music, that Wizard show, Wizards of Wizard, I can't say the damn name, but that's besides the point, whatever. But Lil Mosey is who I'm mainly focused on for this song. I'm here for Lil Mosey because I listen to rap. I listen to pop every now and then, but barely. Like, it's a rare chance he'll catch me. But whenever I do listen to pop, I have listened to Selena Gomez. I do miss her from music. Honestly, I do. To be honest, I do miss her from music, but I don't know who Trevor Daniel is. And I do miss her from music. Heavy. But that's that. This is the Past Life Remix. I have heard like a minute and something about the song, but I haven't heard the full song. But yeah, that's pretty much that. I heard a snippet to this song before. I heard a minute to it, and it sounded good. Now Lil Mosey and Selena Gomez, that's interesting. That's a little bit interesting as a combo. But yeah, that's pretty much that. But without further ado, if y'all do enjoy the video and song, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and share for more. Don't forget to turn post notifications on. And if y'all want to, y'all can go check out my Twitch. My Twitch is in the screen, not in the screen, but on the screen right there. It's also in the description below if y'all want to go check that out. It's much appreciated. And yo, we're about to hit 300 subscribers. Or maybe we're not about to hit, but I want to hit it soon. We're at 276 at this time. Like, at this current recording time, I could be at 277 or 280 by the time this shit goes up. Highly doubt it, but that's that. But I appreciate if y'all can give me the 300 subscribers soon. That'd be crazy. For sure, that'd be a good milestone. But yeah, this is Trevor Daniel, Selena Gomez, Lil Mosey, Past Life Remix. Let's go to get to the video with a song. Let's get it. This song sounds beautiful though, for sure. I'll give it that. This song does sound beautiful.
I'm trying to be honest with my happiness. Don't know why I'm bad at this.
And I don't wanna sit in on my side.
Selena Gomez has a beautiful voice. Yes, she does. A lot of female rappers have a beautiful voice, such as Ariana Grande. I'm waiting for the comments. Who else? Billie Eilish? Yeah, okay. Just in case somebody got mad at me. Oh, you didn't say Billie Eilish, blah, blah, blah. Whatever. Billie Eilish, yeah. She's a good voice, too. Selena Gomez. They all have beautiful voices. For sure. That's 100% true.
I know it's a habit of mine. Perfect. Timing. I start what I don't know how to end.
Sorry. Mind me, I ruined it before it began. Oh.
Dude said he ruined the happiness before it began. That's tough. That's on some emo shit. That's kind of tough.
Last night was the last night, and my past life got me here like you could never figure me out. Last night was the last time, I never let you figure me out. Sitting here talking to myself, thinking how we used to. Only thing I'm used to. Last night was the last time,
This song is beautiful, I'm not gonna cap. This is kind of hitting me. Like, this is something about her voice. I don't know. Just some music like this just kind of hits your soul. You know, whether you can relate to it or not. In any least bit, not saying I do relate to it, but I don't think I do in any least bit. But like, I'm telling you, I feel like everyone relates to a song just a tiny bit. Like, no matter what they're talking about, just a tiny bit. I feel like everyone relates to a song, but I don't relate to this song heavy, in any least bit. But this just sounds beautiful.
gave me what I wanted when I needed it. Honestly, I mean it.
Another thing I wanted to say is, alright, y'all hear what just kicked in, right? No, y'all don't know what I'm talking about? Alright, let me
read it. Gave me what I wanted when I needed it. Honestly, I mean it.
What was that? One more time. Just one more time.
Gave me what I wanted when I needed it. Honestly, I mean it.
You heard it? Y'all heard it that time? Or y'all still don't know what I'm talking about? Whatever. It's 808s. That is something that I love. I love 808s. That's the reason why I love rap. Also the flow, also the way it sounds, and the beats too. They all sound cool. Everyone knows who Logic is. The 1-800 dude. Not what he's known for, but I guess the most recent thing, that's what he's known for, whatever. I could be incorrect, but I'm 99% sure. He had an interview a while ago, a long time ago, saying that, and y'all can correct me if I'm incorrect, or y'all can relate to it too, or like, not relate to it, but understand what I'm saying. He said in a video or interview or something that pop is like rap now, almost. It's like rap and pop are both using 808s. I don't think it was like this in the beginning. It really wasn't. But 808s is something that's been like, I guess you could say revolutionary. And it's like the older generation will sit here and like throw shit at you with their old heads. There's a difference between OGs and old heads, but like they would sit here and throw shit at you for 808s. Rat-tat-tat, rat-tat-tat, yeah, whatever, fuck that shit. It's 808s. That's what I love about the music. Now, y'all can probably relate to me if y'all have been subscribed to my channel. Obviously, y'all like rap. So, obviously, y'all got to agree with me, right? Like, I don't know. But that's pretty much that. I don't know. I like 808s a lot. And I just noticed that a lot, that 808s are all into one pop. So it's like the two genres are coming together, like completely, like when it comes to 808s and shit, right? So yeah, that's just all I really want to say about that topic.
And if I could convince myself to feel it, you know I would feel it, I would. Perfect, perfect timing.
I saw it, I don't know how to end.
This song is beautiful. Give it that. It's gonna be a high rating. I'll tell you that Lil Mosey fucks it up. I'm here for him, so do fucks it up. This shit, that's tough.
I'll never let you figure me out.
Sitting here talking to myself, thinking how I used to. Only thing I'm used to.
Last night was the last night in my past life.
So far, it's probably gonna be like an 8, honestly. Even though that's higher than most of my rap reactions, honestly. But you can recognize good music if you truly are not biased or shit. You can truly recognize good music, even though if you only listen to country, only listen to pop, only listen to rap, any genre, you can recognize good music in it. Me, I only listen to rap. That's honest. I only listen to rap. That's the only genre I truly enjoy for any type of mood. Rap has genres for every single mood that you're in. Like, rap itself is a genre, but this genre is a rap in the middle of it, right? There's like lyrical, there's melodic, there's mumble, little punk, some shit like that. Those are all genres, and then there's Skyload, which is like scream rap, grunge rap, you know. X, I would say, very much popularized the RPX. There's emo rap too. I would say Juice WRLD's a big part of that, RIP Juice WRLD. That's pretty much that. Like, there's just a whole bunch of. I would say rap is its own genre, but it's like a main genre. And there's genres in rap that are all spread it out. Like, there's like sub-genres. If that makes any sense, that's it. But yeah, I feel like, back to the point, I feel like if you truly are not biased or something, you can recognize good music. I feel like this is good music, even though I only listen to rap, personally. But I feel like this is good music. Now, a whole bunch of old heads will probably be like, nah, 808s blew it off. Whatever. It's cool. Own opinion. Everyone's entitled to it, right? Everyone's entitled to it. I love 808s. That's me personally. Due to the last conversation, y'all should probably know that. Damn, this video is getting long. I'm talking a little bit too much. At least I'm giving y'all my reaction to it and talking about it, though. But like I said, I feel like everyone should build a. If you truly are not biased towards music, then you should really be able to recognize good music no matter what genre you listen to. This is good music, in my opinion. Just that.
On them. I'm gon' count again on them. Again. I heard you mad while I'm laughing to the bank. Did what I did, I don't care what you think. What you got?
Do what I do, I don't care what you think. Lil Mosey, this, what? Dude, his expectations sticking pretty high.
Did what I did, I don't care what you think. What you got so much love, I think I'm gon' faint. Hoping you won't change on me, on me, on me. I took a jet by myself across the sea. Cause no one's gon' lie for me, for me, for me. That's how it's gon' be, gon' be, gon' be. What do you want?
Okay, good thing his music, good thing his verse didn't stop, because a lot of like rap artists and everything, am I just noticing this shit by myself? I don't know, I could be completely incorrect, but is it just me, or like every time a newer rap artist is on a song with a been popular artist, such as a pop artist or whatever, right, the verse is like fucking five lines long, and it's like three words per line. Or some shit like that. It's some stupid. Okay, just me. Yeah. No, you agree. You agree? Okay, got you. That's what we said.
It's like me to take what's mine. Tell me what you waiting on. She said,
I'll never let you figure me out.
That was perfect. This song is gonna be like a 9 out of 10. Honestly. This is, I might add this shit, fuck it, you know, like, like, fuck it, look at this shit. Past Life Remix. That's it right there. What the fuck should I put it on? Oh, shit. I'll say casual to the right, why not? Yeah. Stream playlist, Twitch. Shout out Twitch. Vibes, got you. Hey, that's that. Actually, I wanna re-listen to his verse. Y'all probably gonna be like, damn, this video's long as fuck. Like, welcome to reaction channel sometimes. Sometimes it's short, sometimes it's medium, sometimes it's long.
Think I'm gonna faint while I'm laughing to the back.
What? Wait, I didn't get that the first one. First time. I said that we gon' flex on him. We gon' kinda gain.
I heard you mad while I'm laughing to the bank. To the bank. What I did, I don't care what you think. What you got so much love, I think I'm gon' faint.
I have heavy respect for Lil Mosey, by the way. Like, I do. Just do his personality and everything. I've seen him in interviews. I have respect for him.
Hoping you won't change.
Like, the way he portrays, okay, he could be lying. Everyone could lie. Shit, I could lie too. Am I lying? No, not that I would believe. No, like, I'm pretty sure I'm being honest here. But what he portrays himself to be, he's a rapper, right? But like, there's a lot more to someone's story than just being a rapper talking about women or like sex. All that, right? There's a lot more to that than just, that's what a lot of old heads, I could say, would probably category or English, man. That's what a lot of old heads, I would say, would just make fun of them for. I'd be like, oh, they're a rapper. IQ is like -3. Like, on some fuck shit, right? But whenever you really sit down with somebody, right? SoundCloud rapper, too. Dropped out of high school. GED. I mean, that's on some fuck shit sometimes. But you know, everyone's situation is different. Look at Lil Wayne. X. RPX. Oh shit, I forgot what I was talking about. That's kind of tough. But pretty much, damn, I really forgot what the hell I was talking about. This video is getting a little bit way too damn long. But oh yeah, I feel like you really shouldn't judge someone ever. You just gotta sit down with them, you know, and talk like about the past, or not past life, but like, get a little bit in the depth of their life before this shit happen. A lot of people are like, oh, all rappers do, talk about is sex, drugs, women. Okay, that's cool and everything, but think about the background that they came from. It's like, if you religious, I've had this talk with someone before in my family. This is my viewpoint. If you're religious, right, you're probably going to have an issue with somebody cussing and music. Understandable. Somebody who was grown up in the hood, been gang affiliated, you know, ran drugs all their life, struggles from drug addiction. And you sit there and be like, oh, why are they cussing so much in this song? Is that the big deal? Really, it's words. Like, I understand if you're religious or something, but it's like, you expect someone to change. Like, look at their background. Like, would you, then this can go both ways. Like, I would say both people probably wouldn't change if they grew up in the hood and went through a whole bunch of shit. I don't think they're going to be literally like clean, you know. I don't know. That's just me. I think y'all understand what I'm talking about. This video's getting way too damn long.
I took a jet by myself across the sea. Cause no one's gonna lie for me. That's how it's gonna be. What do you want? It's like me to take what's mine. Tell me what you waiting on. She said,
I'll never let you figure me out.
Yeah, this can be like a 9 out of 10. Or close to a 10, honestly. If there was more rap in it, it'd probably be a 10 out of 10 for me. But, yeah, Lamozy.
Sitting here talking to myself, thinking how I used to. Only thing I'm used to. Last night was the last night of my past life.
Damn. Alright, I kind of got lost there at the end. This song kind of put me in a little bit of a loss. Like, holy shit. Like, damn. Beautiful song. everything was perfect. I wish not perfect. I don't know what actually perfect is. But I would just say, like, you know, off my opinion, it's close to perfect, whatever. 10 out of 10. Give that a 9. It's a 9. But that's, I already talked way too damn much. Yo, I don't got nothing to say at the end of the video. Go check out the damn song. It's good. Let me know down in the comments below how y'all feel about the reaction in the song. Give me some feedback, positive, or you can give me some negative feedback too. I really don't give a fuck, but preferably positive, you know, spread positivity on this earth, you know, especially on a fucking website that's toxic like yourself. Yeah, but anyway, it's been JC. I hope y'all have an amazing day and night, whatever time you're watching this. Everyone stay positive. I've been trying to say that every single video for my outro. I feel like that's something that you just gotta tell people sometimes and remind people to do. Don't beat yourself up. Stay positive. Do the right thing. And y'all already know. It's been JC. Later.